Per favore, attenzione. Finale dei 100 metri piani femminili. Corsia numero 1. Jennifer Smart, Gran Bretagna. Corsia numero 2. Giuseppina Leone, Italia. Corsia numero 3.
Ever since she been born.
One thing after another. She got the scarlet fever, then pneumonia.
Long she been having trouble walking?
Oh, a couple weeks. Ever since she got old pneumonia.
You're a cute little honey, ain't you? Your mama and daddy tell me you don't like to eat.
She always come through the fever, all right. But she never growed like the others.
I got me 8 children, but only 7 of them to feed. This one don't eat nothing.
You know, you gotta eat, little honey, if you wanna be big like your brothers and sisters. You gonna do that for me? It's a good little honey.
Need any bond? Go play with your sisters.
Well, Elaine's alive, and that's a good sign. She's not hurting. But the sickness and not eating. These are the growing years. Child's leg has not been growing right. You know the Meharry Hospital in Nashville?
Mm-hmm.
Got fine doctors there, specialists. Child needs special treatment.
Nashville's 50 miles from here. Me and Ed works every day. Is my Harry open on Saturday?
9 in the morning on. They got buses to take about 2 hours. So Dr. Gordon there will handle the case.
See what I'm doing? Got to get some life in there. Now, this has got to be done 3 times a day, a half hour without stopping, and you can't miss a one. Now, that's every day now, and all week long. Then you got to come in here Saturday, and we'll do it again in the water. Now, how you like to swim in the pot, little lady? Well, little lady, don't you want to play and be able to go to school like all the rest of the kids? Then you got to start doing everything me and your mama tells you. Means you gotta come in here Saturday and do some more swimming. And if you don't do it, you won't be able to play and go to school. Now, tell me what you gotta do.
Listen to you and Mama, eat more.
What about the swimming?
I don't like swimming.
Is she gonna walk regular?
I can't tell. She's not gonna get any worse. How much better? Who knows? like shooting dice. You don't know nothing till you throw. She gotta have a brace, and cause her leg needs support, and she gotta stay off it.
Like I said before, me and my husband, we works every day, Doc.
Did you say you have 7 other kids?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3
reverse.
Okay, Linda. Your turn.
Oh! Ah!
You pull that thumb off.
I said you do it like this, nice and easy. One, two, three, four. Okay, now try again.
Up, two, three, four. Down, two, three, four. Up, two, three, four. Down, two, three, four. Up, two, three, four.
What's gonna be? What's gonna be with the little one, honey? Wilma's sick.
You okay?
Why is she having a supper?
She ain't hungry.
Something wrong?
Uh-huh. Something wrong, kid?
I didn't do nothing to her.
I didn't do nothing.
Sometimes it ain't what you do. Sometimes it's what you don't do. Lots of times people be doing mean things and they don't know they're doing mean things.
What you talking about, Mama?
Now you all hear me. And hear me good. Especially you, Tootie, and Charlene, because you're all his girls. And the rest of you, you just listen to me good. Because we is all one family. Now, y'all is good kids. And I know you love your sister. But loving Wilma is not enough. Y'all gotta treat her special. Now, I know you don't mean her no bad, but she ain't never had what you got. She ain't got no friends. The kids at school, they all make fun of how she walks. There she is, 12 years old, and shut up like a beanstalk. She's a whole head taller than all the other kids, and they make fun of her for that. Now, it ain't been easy on Wilma, and your kids is all she got.
Well, what are we supposed to do, Mama?
Now, you all has just got to take a little care in what Wilma's thinking. When you're playing your basketball, just make sure that Wilma gets her turn.
Mama, if Wilma play, we're gonna lose the ball game. She shoots the ball all right, but she can't run.
You don't always have to win. You can win for losing. You do your best, and you win it. The Lord don't take nothing from nobody except they do their best. Now, Tootie, you don't win every game you play at the high school, do you?
No, Mama.
And you're doing your best.
Yes, ma'am.
And Wilma is doing her best. Now, of course, she can't run like everyone else. You got to do better than you've been doing. So that makes you better. Then everybody gets something.
Your Mama is right. You got to take care of your sister. Special care.
What you doing?
Hey, Robert, get the ball, Robert.
My name is Robert Eldridge. And I
figured it was Robert something.
I play basketball at your house with your brothers and sisters in the backyard. Did you see my last basket?
No.
Man, you really missed something. Fake two guys with a dip to do, then sunk it. It was really something. Where you going?
Nowhere.
You want to shoot some baskets?
No.
You want to go for a swim?
Yeah.
How long you got to keep wearing those shoes?
I don't know.
Can you walk without them?
Guess so.
Did you ever try?
A couple of times. Doctor says gotta keep wearing until I get bigger.
Know something?
What?
You pretty big now.
When I can walk regular, I'll really show you how to do a dipsy-do.
I thought you said you didn't see me do my dipsy-do.
How could nobody see? You make such a big fuss about showing everybody.
Thank you.
Something wrong?
Your papa's going, it's his business. Go on inside.
Papa ain't going to church, is he?
Your papa want to go to church, you go to church.
Well, papa never goes to church.
Now, you just hush up about what your papa does.
Mama, you making papa go to church?
Your mama don't make your papa do nothing he don't want to do. We was not yelling, Miss Lady. We was discussing. Discussing. Now, if y'all don't hush up, y'all gonna hear some real yelling. Wilma, go on inside and see how your papa's doing.
Yes, Mom. Papa, Mama wants me to see how you's doing.
Oh, I'm doing just fine.
That's good.
Wilma, honey, your Mama and me had a talk. And this is for you. Just fine. Go show your mama.
Mama.
Oh. Now listen. These are your church shoes. Now when you come home, you change them. And in time, you'll be wearing them all the time, yes. Lord willing. Now listen, I gotta get out of here. I'm already late for the choir. You all come along with your papa here.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye.
You think she's funny? Okay. 5 times around the gym and no stop.
Judy, I sure wish you was still out there.
Are you kidding?
Well, your sister's gonna beat to death to me. She is plumb lazy. Don't take no offense, honey, but she got enough talent. Just break all your scoring records. She's scoring 20 points a game, and that's about half of what she can do. Wait. Girls, okay, so y'all don't go and die on me right on this spot. That's all for now. I ain't got no money for mass funerals. Guys! Move closer to me! Run it! Run it! Let's go! Oh,
Coach, why you got to be so hard?
You ain't seen nothing yet, Peter. Now, you're either going to start moving your butt, or you're going to get sores on your butt, because you're going to be the highest scoring bench warmer that ever played here. Just you see how many points you're going to score sitting down.
What's the ball, Peter?
You have to be.
Robert, there's a practice going on.
Sorry, Coach.
Okay, go change. That's another thing. Best darn ball players I got are stuck on each other. She sure moves her butt when Robert's around. Judy, how your mama and papa feel about Skeeter being away for the summer? What? I've been thinking. I had a talk with the referee after last Saturday night's game, Ed Temple. He's over Tennessee State, the coach's track team. Wilma don't know him yet, but he knows her. He refereed about 6 of our games. And him and me have been talking about running since I started the track team last year. He says that all Skeeter needs is some good training, and she'd really be something.
She gotta go away for the whole summer?
Temple runs his summer school. It's like a clinic. When he's out refereeing around the state, he sees hundreds of kids. And he asks the ones that he thinks got something over to the college for the summer and trains them.
I think Mama will be okay, but I don't know about Papa. See, Skeeter's only 15, and Papa don't want to have happen to her what happened to me.
Well, nothing gonna happen to Skeeter. She's safer with Temple than she'd be in a church. Lights out, 9 o'clock every night. If he thinks she's got something, she'd get to go to college.
I'll talk to Mama, and I'll see what she said.
Come on.
Ain't got much time, Mr. Temple.
I got plenty of time. You just worry about getting this mail around. Let me worry about the time. And you can quit giving me one of your looks. Now it's time. Ladies and gentlemen, I notice from your occasional stirring whenever your sleep is interrupted by the raising of my voice that you have joined with the detractors of the subject of sociology who claim that we spend a lot of time and money to document the obvious. Well, now, if that's what you think, you may well be right. Sociology has been called a bastard science. Oh, I see some movement amongst you. You have recognized the word. Now, the eyes all closed when I talk about interaction, but the eyes open wide when I say bastard. Well, truth is truth. Our subject starts off with parents who ain't married. Socius, from the Latin, logos, from the Greek. One entire word coming from different cultures, different traditions, different ways of life. So you say, so what? So I say plenty, that's what. Example, World War II, Guadalcanal. Now the American army is here and the Japanese army is over there. It is nighttime and these two enemies are within shouting distance of each other. It is nighttime, it is dark, it is scary. And everybody is nervous. Ain't nobody sleeping. As soon as there's a sound, everybody's grabbing for their guns. I mean, scared is scared is scared. So what is sociology got to do with Japanese and Americans being scared? Right.
Nothing.
But shoot, look what happens. Now, one of the Americans, he gets angry. Now, he's angry because he ain't had no sleep in 3 nights, so he starts off yelling, Hirohito's a dirty chicken pucker. Now, you can guess what he was really yelling. Hirohito's a dirty chicken pucker. Now, there's some activity on the Japanese side, and pretty soon, all Americans are yelling, Hirohito's a dirty chicken plucker. Hirohito's a dirty chicken plucker. And the Japanese suddenly fill the night air with screams. Banzai! Banzai! And they come charging the Americans. Bow, 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 bow. All night long, the Americans are yelling, Hirohito's a dirty chicken plucker, and all night long, the Japanese are charging and getting popped off. Well, you see what happened, don't you? The Japanese love their emperor. And ain't nobody can insult their emperor, so they come charging. Now, it's the next night, and it's just as black, and it's just as scary, and everybody just as nervous. This time, Japanese that shot. Roosevelt's a dirty chicken plucker! Roosevelt's a dirty chicken plucker! Now, the Japanese, get ready for the attack. But shoot, ain't no attack. American jail back. You darn right Roosevelt's the chicken plucker. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here. Now that's sociology.
Now, there's one other thing. I'm gonna tell you what you're thinking because it's gonna stop you from asking. Now, all afternoon, you've been doing your wind sprints and your exercises and your starts, right?
Right, right. Right.
And that's what all sprinters are supposed to do, right?
Right.
And you all sprinters that hope to be good enough to make the Tennessee State team, right?
Right.
Now, I'm going to tell you what you're thinking. If we all sprinters, why is this man now gonna send us out on some cross-country running?
Oh,
yeah. Right. Now that you voiced your satisfaction with cross-country running, I'm gonna tell you why you're gonna commune with nature. Now, you gonna run cross-country for one reason and one reason only. You wanna know what that reason is? The reason is that colored kids ain't supposed to run cross country because colored kids is only supposed to run sprints. Now, this team here at Tennessee State is gonna upset that popular theory. Now, how's that for a good enough reason for you? You realize you're gonna be pioneers? That you're gonna prove to the whole world that colored kids can run more than 100 yards?
Coach, I wanted to accept the inevitable fact of life that colored kids can only run sprints.
Well, now, that's where you and me differ. Because I ain't willing to accept that fact of life. I think running cross country gonna be good for you. Gonna perk you up a little. Give you a chance to look at some cows and some horses and some trees. Maybe. Just maybe. Maybe those lungs will hold a little more oxygen so that you're running at full steam doing that last 10 yards when you need it. Maybe those legs get a little stronger so that when you gotta run 6 races in one day, you won't be dragging like you dragging now. And maybe while you out there among the cows and the horses, you can cuss old Temple and he ain't gonna know about it. Maybe one day when you win a medal because you've been able to stay longer than anybody else and your picture's in the paper, maybe then you remember what old Temple told you. That colored kids can run more than just sprints.
Thank you.
that your name?
Yes, sir.
So, what do you want?
You're going to talk to my mom and pop at the game next week.
Girl, I got me a basketball game here at a referee, and I expect you got one to play. You the captain?
No, sir.
Well, then get out of here. I'm talking only to captain. Yeah!
I told Skeeter we're going to drop over and see her mom and papa after the game next week.
Rudolph?
Yes, sir?
How come they call you Skeeter?
I don't know.
That's my doing. Just like a mosquito, she's fast, always buzzing around, getting in my way. If she ain't buzzing, she's sleeping.
Rudolph, I want to give you some philosophy. You know what philosophy is?
No, sir.
Philosophy is thinking. It ain't like arithmetic. 2 and 2 is 4, and no matter what you hear, it ain't ever gonna be 5. Well, philosophy is different. Different people think different ways about the same thing. I know what you're thinking. You mad at me. You think I'm mad at you. Now I'm gonna give you some tempo philosophy. That's my philosophy. It ain't got nothing to do with Coach Gray's philosophy, you understand? Now I'm refereeing your game this afternoon, and I'm there to see that each team is treated equal. Each player gets an equal shake. And you come running up to me saying, hi, I'm Skeeter, because you all hopped up because you think you might be coming to my summer camp. Well, now, I shoo you off, because you're there to play a game, and I'm there to referee one. I don't want none of the other players, and I don't want none of the people watching to get the idea that you're more than equal. Now, that's my philosophy. You got it, Rudolph?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Coach Temple ain't making no promises, but lots of girls who he's been training summer, he's got them to go to Tennessee State.
Yeah. None of our kids has ever went to college.
But she got plenty of speed, I'll say that for her. But she don't know what to do with it.
Where's she gonna sleep?
At college. She'd be there with the other girls, about 20 girls. They all there together. They got their own beds. We give them uniforms, food. You just got to give her a little spending change, that's all. Some of the older girls from the college, they spend their summers helping the new kids out.
How come you doing all this?
Well, sir, it works both ways. Now, your daughter got a chance for a college education. And if she turns out to be as good as I think she can be, team's got itself a good runner.
How much all this cost?
Nothing. College pays for everything. Don't cost nothing.
You want to go, child?
Yes, Papa.
Your Papa want to talk to these folks, child.
Yes, Papa.
She ain't never been away from here for more than a few hours. Don't know much about schooling and running. I know my little girl had lots of bad times when she was growing. Don't want no more bad times. Her sister, Tootie, she did all this running and schooling before her. All she got was bad. Tootie's a mama. Child ain't got no papa. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir, I do. Mr. Rudolph, I got rules. And they rules like for my own child. No car rides. None of the girls goes no place by themselves. Bed at 9 o'clock.
I got me Pappy Marshall. He takes care of the equipment in the field, and he watches the girls like he's their papa. Your little girl break any of my rules, I'll send her home faster than you can shake a stick.
Won't say okay. But this one ain't gonna have no more bad times. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
First couple of days are rough, but after that it gets easier. You'll love it. You'll have a great time.
Well, do you ever get to go out at night?
Oh, no, never.
Hi. My name's Martha Hudson. I'm from McRae, Georgia.
I'm Skeeter Rudolph. I'm from Bud High School.
Did you sign in yet?
No.
Oh, how'd you get so tall?
I don't know. I just keep growing.
Oh, I wish I could be that tall.
Oh, I wish I could give you some.
What's that?
Oh, that's Mae Fags. She's in college here. She's a champion.
She go to college?
Mm-hmm. Right here at Tennessee State.
All right, 2 minutes, girls.
She run in the Olympics.
What for?
Because she's the best.
Oh, well, where are the Olympics?
Oh, different places. Every 4 years they have an Olympics. They're going to have one next year.
Where?
I think this... Mae?
Yes, honey?
You know Skeeter Rudolph?
Hi, Skeeter.
Hey.
You as big as Coach Temple say. Coach Temple say I got to watch out for you.
What for?
Say you as fast as lightning.
Oh.
Where the Olympics? Next year in Australia. See you later.
Okay.
Maybe when you're not doing nothing, you can show me how to shoot some baskets.
Oh, sure.
Oh, girl, she nice. She know about my basketball playing. Mm-hmm. You say she a champion. Girl, you should see me do my gypsy do. Me and Robert do it all the time.
All right, gather around. Now, you know, girls, I'm Pappy Marshall. And for those of you who have been here before, you have your own names for me. Now, next to Coach Temple, I'm the law. Now, just in case you get an idea that you want to break any of the rules, remember I have eyes behind my head. I have ears that can hear an ant crawl a mile away. And I have a voice that is so boomy that it will raise my granddaddy from his grave.
Same speech Peppy gave every summer. Can't see a foot in front of his eyes. I can't hear a cannon shot if he fires. Everybody loves me.
And I got legs that can give a squirrel a 10-yard start and catch him before he moves. And that's only the beginning.
All right, you can waste your breath down there talking if you want to, but you're going to need some air to get to the end of the line. And you will get to the end of the line. On the mark. Set. Go! All right, get those knees up. Get those knees up. Lean and pull. Lean and pull. Lean and pull. Dead, 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 dead. All right, exercise.
Dear Mom and Papa, I'll be home soon because I don't think I'm doing so good. The girls are nice, but Coach Temple, he's crazy. When we first got here, every day we had to run 6 miles for breakfast. Then Coach Temple said we had to run another 6 miles for lunch. At 3 o'clock, Coach Timber said we have to run another 6 miles, so that's what we do. So after 2 weeks, Coach Timber said our communion with nature time is over. And now we gotta begin the real training.
Get.
All right. On the line, Matthews, Daniels, Rudolph, Tide. You go one more time. What we gonna do now? On the mark, we breathe easy. Set, we take a deep breath. On the gun, we go. One more time. On the mark, breathe easy. Set, suck it in. Bam, you go. You got that?
Yes, sir.
You got that?
Yes, sir.
On the mark. Set. Where you going, girl? Set. All right, everybody up. You getting ready for a fist fight, Rudolph? This ain't no prize fighting team. You got your fists all balled up like you want to fight. You trying to dig yourself to China with your fist, Rudolph?
No, sir.
This here's a running race. On your mark. Set. Go.
Dig. Dear Robbie, I've been here 4 weeks and everything's going wrong. Every day we do lots of exercises. Coach Temple calls it loosening up. 2 weeks ago, Coach Temple began telling us the correct way to run, how we should start, how we should breathe, how we should lean forward instead of backward. Then when everybody can hardly move, we start having races.
On your mark. Set. That's not what I showed you, Rudolph.
Well, I was doing all right at home.
Girl, you here because you want to be a Tennessee State Tiger Belle, and that's the best. You want to be the best, you do it my way, or you get. Now, set. All right. Ready. Go!
There's something wrong with Coach Temple's thinking. At the high school, I won every race I was ever in, and Coach Temple said it don't mean nothing because I'm running wrong. Now he says I'm running right, and I ain't won a race yet. I made my decision. I'm coming home.
Come in. You sick?
No, I want to go home.
That's so. You miss your mama and your papa? Well, when you stop doing whatever it is you're doing, maybe I know what's bothering you. The other girl's bothering you? Well, then what's bothering you?
Nothing.
Well, that's settled. Nothing's bothering you, and you want to go home. You want to go today? All right.
Well, don't you want to know why I want to go home?
I already asked you, and you said nothing.
Well, ever since I got here, I can't do nothing right. My legs are too long, and I don't know what to do with my hands.
Now, I'm going to tell you something, girl. I'm going to tell you this one time and one time only, right here and now today. You've been blessed. You've been blessed with long arms and legs. Instead of standing there crying, you ought to be thanking God that he blessed you. I'll get my car and drive you to the bus station.
I ain't packed yet.
How you gonna go home if you ain't packed yet? Listen. You go and get yourself some breakfast, yeah? All right. But there's one more thing. Now you go home when I tell you to go home, right? All right.
good. She packed everything.
Coach, I never knew running took so much strength.
Most important thing, are you getting it?
Yeah, my head wants to, but my arms, my legs, they don't listen. Coach Temple said I'm blessed. Such a thing is too much blessing.
You playing any basketball?
Well, every chance I get, which is never, Coach Temple said. But you, you're here to learn running, and that's all you're here for.
Well, I've been playing every day. Now I got to get ready for the football season.
Everybody know you're a football, basketball star, Robert.
Well, I didn't say that.
Well, that's what you meant.
Well, girl,
come on, Robert Elder, stop now.
Mom and Papa okay?
Mama's okay, but Papa don't work as much as before.
He all right, ain't he?
Yeah, but, you know, doctor said he just need a little more rest.
Guess what, Coach? We're going to Philadelphia.
So Coach Temple say?
Going running 3 relays. Coach Temple says the national championship. Girl from the whole country come. Gonna have 2 teams, and I'm on the junior team. I'm gonna run the 100, the 75, and the relay. Martha, girl, come here, come here. This is Martha Hudson. This is Coach Gray.
How you doing?
This is Robert Elder.
Oh, how are you?
That's my sister Tootie and her baby.
Tootie.
Martha's my best friend.
Yeah.
We run the relays together.
How's she doing, Martha?
Skeeter don't like beating anybody that's older. She could have won lots of races.
And Coach Temple say in the beginning you want to go home because you can't beat nobody.
That's before I knew I could beat him. Once you know in your heart you can win, it don't matter if you win.
Skeeter, I'm gonna give you some Coach Gray philosophy. If you know you can win, and the other girls know you can win, then you better win. Because if you don't, the other girls gonna think you're playing with them. You're all running for Coach Temple, your team, huh? If you win, Martha wins. If Martha wins, you win. That's why Coach Temple has y'all training together. It's the same as with a basketball team. Some night, you don't score your 20 points. So Sarah Curtis scores 20, and we win anyway.
Sarah Curtis ain't never gonna score no 20 points.
Skeeter don't like no Sarah Curtis.
Sarah Curtis keep giving you those eyes, can't score nothing. Can't score nothing with no 2 black eyes.
Well, Skeeter, honey, let me be the first to give you the information. Sarah Curtis already has 2 black eyes.
Oh, Robert, you always playing with me now. I want to get 2 black eyes.
I give.
Why don't you wait for the sun to go down?
Child will be home soon. Want to make the basketball ready.
Take another week's time. They're all going to Philadelphia.
What for?
She's running there. Coach Temple taking all the girls.
She's doing a lot of traveling for a little girl.
Well, that's the way it be sometimes. She in good hands.
I want to make sure she settled down before I...
You planning on going somewhere?
What's this running doing for? Don't want her leg go bad again.
Well, now, Coach Temple done said her leg's getting stronger. She done passed the hard times. Oh.
That fella a doctor?
Well, now, he ain't no doctor. But just like you, he know the child something special.
You know, he called the other day from the college, wanted to know if you let Skeeter go to Philadelphia. I told him that you were sleeping. But unless you said no, it was okay.
Why don't you tell me?
Lord have mercy. When she around the house, you don't pay her no mind. When she ain't around, you want to know where she be. Big cloud coming overhead. Looks like you got about 15 minutes time.
Attention, please. Will Dr. Walker please report to the finish line? Dr. Walker, please report to
okay,
the finish
yeah,
line.
Yeah. Hudson, going over there to that honey. Come on, girl, let's go. Let's go. Let's move it. Keep him married. The rest of y'all be warmed up now. I don't want you getting all tight.
Repeat.
Hey, girl.
Will
girl.
All medal winners up, please report to the official's table.
Senior relay. Let's go, girls. Come on, Tiger Bells.
Let's
go. Over there to the starting line. White way out, girl.
Girls,
come on,
girl.
Come on,
girl.
You got the senior team.
The winner, Wilma Rudolph, Clarksville, Tennessee.
Keep your arms second, loose here. Keep moving. Keep moving.
Linda Johnson.
Thanks.
Dallas, Texas.
Yeah, child. You got the 100-yard senior. Get off there. Keep them arms moving. Keep them going. Right close. That's a good race, Skeeter. Senior relay, let's go, girls. Come on. Let's go. Let's go. Move on out there to the starting line. Let's go, women. Look for them Tiger Bells. All right, Skeeter.
Huh?
Skeeter, you got the 100 junior semifinal.
Oh, Dad, but
you don't open with Hudson now, girl. Let's move it. The rest of you, keep them bodies warm. Keep moving. Come on, girl. Come on. Come on. Let's keep going.
Of the high school 100-yard dash.
You sleep, Rudolph? Y'all deal real good today.
Always gonna have to run 9 races in one day, Coach. I don't mind the finals, but all in heaps.
Shoot. I don't know what you're complaining about. You won them all. You know, when I was running, my coach used to say, only the losers get tired.
Know something, Coach?
What's that?
Your coach didn't know nothing.
A lot of people out there watching was mighty impressed with you today. Talking about you going to Australia, making the Olympic team.
Someone else gonna have to go, Coach. I'm too tired.
Morning.
Morning.
Girl, you're gonna get yourself an upside down stomach.
I'm gonna be late, Mama.
A man called from the Nashville newspaper. He say he want to talk to you. He say Coach Temple say, now you done won a medal and had all that experience at the Melbourne Olympics. Ain't no reason why you can't win a gold medal at the next Olympics. He say he coming by on Sunday.
Alarm clock didn't go off and Robert gonna be mad. He making me a picnic.
Listen, picnic ain't worth no upside down stomach now. Sorry, the bugs gonna still be waiting for you even if you're 10 minutes late. Here, where?
It ain't the picnic, Mama. It's the kissing after.
Slow down, young lady. Now, Robert can't leave till he gets here.
Hi, Robert L.
Morning, Skeeter. Morning, Mr. Rudolph. Mrs. Rudolph.
Morning.
Star, have a ride.
Hush up, Wes.
Got to get moving, Skeeter.
Oh, okay.
Just a few minutes, Robert. I'll be ready in just a few minutes.
I said hush up.
Oh, stop it. Bye, Papa. Kiss, kiss, Mama.
Where's she going to go?
Where's she going on the picnic? Now, you know where she's going.
Where's she going to go when the high school done?
Oh, she's going to go to college with Coach Temple.
He going to college?
You mean Robert? Now, Robert's gonna get a job and work like everyone else that went to the high school. What you worried about Robert for?
Hey, keeping company.
Lord have mercy. Now, if Skeeter and Robert going together means they's keeping company, they's keeping company. What you think about it? Well, now ain't nothing gonna stop Skeeter from going to college.
Robert?
Huh?
How long we known each other?
Long time. From the time you couldn't walk good.
I can hardly remember when I couldn't walk good. Did you ever want to go out with the other girls?
Sure, but I was afraid you'd kill me.
See, I knew it, Robert.
I never wanted to go out with no other girls. Not steady.
That's okay. You know why?
No.
Because I think we're something special. And I always want us to be something special.
When you was in Australia at the Olympics and when you was at college in the summers and I couldn't see you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's when I knew we were something special.
I'm fine. Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah. Sure. Sure. Thank you. Yeah, Coach Temple, would you get my home, please? CB? Yeah, you okay? Kids okay? Everything okay? Yeah, darling, I'm fine. CB, I just got a call from the United States Olympic Committee in New York. They want me to coach the women's track team in the Rome Olympics. Yeah, darling. Yeah, darling. Yeah. I love you too.
What's eating you? I just threw you a pass.
Well, just you throw it when I'm looking.
Okay, you looking?
Another fight between you two, huh?
I don't know, Coach. Every day is something else.
A leg bothering her?
She don't say. Things are different, though.
How so?
Well, when she come back from the Olympics 2 years ago with a medal, I thought she'd act up something then. All the newspaper stories and radio interviews, all the other girls acting up and being jealous, whispering behind her back, laughing and giggling, you know, saying funny things. Well, first time they talk about how big she was, call her funny looking and coach's pet, making fun of us going together, saying Skeeter going with me. Because now that she's an Olympic star, she got to go out with a hotshot basketball and football captain, you know, like in the movies. But me and Skeet have been going together 5 years before she went to Australia.
Robert. Now, it's none of my business. You don't have to talk about it if you don't want to. But you and Skeet ever discuss what's going to happen later on?
Sure, all the time. Shoot, I love Skeet from the very first. Same with her. I get married tomorrow. All Skeet want to do is go to the Rome Olympics. Coach Temple say
She could win a gold medal if she'd be with him 2 years after college. And that's what she gonna do.
She worried about her papa?
Yeah, sure, she worried. But no more than before. Now, we talk about her papa all the time. And she tell me all the time, when papa go, I got to look after her all the time. And I tell her papa ain't going nowhere. And she gets a little teary-eyed and tells me she know papa got to go sometime. And how glad she is and how lucky she is to have me here to look after.
Well, something's bugging her. It's a good thing Temple ain't around. You think twice about winning that gold medal.
So what I want you to do is you go through here and you figure out which ones are the new ones. And you get copies of that run off so that all my people... come on in, darling. Yeah. All right. Come on in. Come on, darling. You remember the last time you was in here? You wanted to go home. I talked with the coach. He worried about you. You and the baby. When you gonna have it?
5 months in July.
Your mommy and daddy know?
Papa's sick. Mama specs up.
Well, you gotta tell them. It ain't the end of the world. What about Robert?
You know I want to get married after.
After what?
The Olympics.
Well, that's 2 years away. What about the baby?
I don't know.
What you're saying is you want me to talk to your mama and papa. Now, you know I promised him nothing was going to happen to you. You make sure he knows before I get there. Go on. Hot summer. Well, how's your husband feeling?
Good days and bad. Would you like a glass of iced tea?
Oh, thank you kindly. See your husband. Was he here? Sleeping?
No, he's out in the back.
Yeah.
to it. Afternoon, sir. Sure is a hot day. You mind if I sit down? I just wanted you to know that when all this business is over, I still would like Wilma to come to the college. None of this makes no difference with me.
She ain't going to no college.
Well, like I say, what the college don't know don't hurt it. College don't have to know, and I surely would like her to come.
What you want don't mean nothing. She gonna stay here.
It's okay. I just want you to know my thinking.
I told you this one ain't gonna have no more bad times.
That's right. Well, she's been at the college in my summer program for the last three summers. Ain't nothing happened to her. She's been halfway around the world to the Olympics in Australia, and ain't nothing happened to her. Kids don't have no experience with these kind of things.
The child gonna be her mama. She gonna take care of her child like her mama.
Maybe you'd like to think about it. You know, she did real good last time out, and this time she might do even better.
All the thinking's done. All the talking's done.
Well. I just wanted you to know my feelings. Good day to you, sir. Talk to me.
Talk to me.
Well, you want me to talk to your papa?
Papa ain't talking to nobody right now, especially you. He don't want you near the house no more. I'm sorry, Rob. It ain't your fault.
What's wrong with getting married?
Robert, you know I love you, right? But if we get married now, everything is lost. School, the Olympics. And I know I don't want to ever lose you.
I told Coach Gray, I tell your mama and your papa
And I'm telling you, I love you. I love you more than anything. And whatever you want to do, that's what I want to happen for you. So you got one less worry. I'll always be here.
Well, miss, your mama. Keita, I don't want you to say nothing. I want you to just listen to your mama a little bit. When I first met your papa, I was as young as you is now. Your papa was as old as my papa. When the Lord took his wife away, he come to me with 14 children, all of them fully grown. And your papa and me, we got married. And first come Roosevelt, and then George, then Nita, and Toadie, and then here you come, small, in all the years I lay by his side, I had never seen him cry once. Not once. And Wilma, he cried over you all the time. 'Cause from the first, you was something special. Wilma, your papa, oh, he's something special. He works so hard sometimes. He's too tired to eat his supper, taking this job here and this job there. But there ain't never been a day when there wasn't something to eat. Now, he ain't never been man with words. When you come back from Melbourne and the Olympics, oh, he was so proud. Didn't show it. Sometimes, when he ain't talking, I could tell just what he's thinking. Well, your papa's angry. Oh, he's angry. 'Cause it's time back come. And now he ain't even got you. You growed and gonna be a mama. Well, he ain't angry 'cause you're gonna be a mama. He angry at Coach Gray and Coach Temple and Robert, 'cause they all done took you away from him. All these years, child, your papa been fussing over you. I just think it's time you did a little fuss.
James Eason, president of the Science Club. Bellamy Baker, member of the Student Council, president of the Honor Society. Elza Smith, treasurer of the student body, member of the basketball team, graduating with an average of 88 in all subjects. Wilma Rudolph, captain of the championship basketball team, captain of the championship track team, winner of a bronze medal at the 1956 Melbourne Olympic Games, recipient of an athletic scholarship to Tennessee State University. Mary Ellis, honor student and president of the History Club. Alex Clark, president of the Science Club.
Hello, Papa. I know you're angry, Papa. But there's something I gotta tell you. Rob and me, we should have waited. But we didn't know nothing. Now I'm gonna have a baby. And I still don't know nothing. But I want to know things. I want to learn things in college. And I want to try to go to the Olympic Games. But most of all, I want the baby to have what I had. Coach Gray, he taught me how to play basketball, and that was good. Coach Temple, he taught me how to run track, and that was good. But you and Mama's my home. You's everything I really love. And I can do without the basketball. And I can do without the track. But I can't do without you and Mama. I only remember a couple things in my life, Papa. I remember sitting on your lap and you talking to me when I was sick. And I remember you gave me my first pair of real shoes. And I remember all the times we used to sit at the dinner table, eating and talking. That's what I remember, Papa. And that's what I want my baby to have. You and Mama. Because that's the best I could give her. That's what I want, Papa.
And I was named coach of the women's track team. Now, that was good. That was good for Tennessee State. That was good for me. And, well, seven of the girls from the college is here today. And that's good for you. Good for Tennessee State. Good for the country. Now, some of you gonna win some medals today. But what I'm talking about ain't winning no medals. It's doing your best. Better than you ever done before. But that's all I'm asking. And that's what this here thing is all about. Your best. Your very, very best. Well, that's all for right now. It's easy time from here on in. All you got to do is a little jogging, some limbering up. And get plenty of rest. All right? Okay, let's hit it. Go on.
So hard to be a tiger.
Look out, girls. Lay back, honey. Lay back. Easy. What happened?
Trying to miss the water sprinkler. Stepped in a hole.
All right. How'd that feel?
It hurt.
How'd that feel?
It hurt.
Well, it ain't broken. All right, let's get up. See if you can walk on it. All right, take it easy. Take it easy. Okay, let's go. How'd that feel?
They hurt, but I
could walk them. All right, let's get inside. How'd that feel?
I don't know. Let me walk on it.
All right. Take it easy now. Take it easy. Well, how'd it feel?
It hurt, but I could walk them.
All right, give me that ice bucket. Get up here on the table now. I'm gonna pack this in some ice. Keep the swelling down. Then we tape it up real tight. And if it don't swell up on you, you're gonna be all right.
You know something, Coach?
What's that?
Life sure is a funny thing.
Yeah?
I ain't never told you, but you know the only scare I've been having?
What?
Is that the bad one would go?
Per favore, attenzione. Finale dei 100 metri piani femminili. Corsia numero uno. Jennifer Smart, Gran Bretagna. Corsia numero due, Giuseppina Leone, Italia. Corsia numero tre, Wilma Rudolph, Stati Uniti. Corsia numero quattro, Maria Itkina, Unione Sovietica. Corsia numero 5, Catherine Capdeville, Francia. Corsia numero 6, Dorothy Hyman, Gran Bretagna.
Ognuno nella sua corsia. Prepararsi alla partenza. Pronti?
Thank you.
Corsia numero uno. Wilma Rudolph, Stati Uniti. Giuseppina Leone, Italia. Dorothy Hyman, Gran Bretagna. Maria Itkina, Unione Sovietica.
Ognuno nella sua corsia. Prepararsi alla partenza.
Wilma, she's on the phone.
You coming home?
Yeah, Papa. Papa?
Yeah.
I miss you and Mom. I want to come home.
When you coming home?
Papa?
Yeah.
How's our baby?
She right here.
Well, give her a big kiss for me, Papa.
Uh-huh. Coming home?
Papa?
Yeah.
Take care of yourself, Papa.
When you coming home?
I love you, Papa.
All right.